So today we are going to make a quiche gluten-free with a sweet potato crust and a lot of goodies inside. We're starting from a recipe from this website, and then we're going to make some small modifications to our flavor and see what's gonna come out. Anyways, let's go! Okay, so first we're gonna chop the onions. And just so you know, we're doing half of the recipe. So today I will be using 6 eggs, a bundle of spinach, 1 small onion, 12 ounces of sweet potato, about half of a big one, 1 cup of feta cheese, half a cup of Greek yogurt, olive oil and salt and pepper. So let's peel our sweet potato. Here we want to aim for cubes, about half an inch. Little bit of salt. Okay, so right now we are frying the sweet potatoes. They are starting to look nice, caramelized, nice toasted on the outside. So I'm using this one instead of like the bigger one because we are halving the recipe and it will look a little bit nicer in this one. So I don't know if this is going in the good way, but I'm pressing lightly. But they are still pretty stubborn, so we'll see what happens. There are still gaps. Okay, so we're going to use something a little heavier than the back of a spoon, because we should try to make a crust, so let's just start mushing. And now it's probably a good time to preheat the oven to 300 degrees Fahrenheit or 150 degrees Celsius. In the meantime, we are going to saute our onions, so we want them soft but not browned. So from the recipe is the remaining 3 tablespoons of olive oil, but I'll just wing it. So in the recipe, from this website, it calls for kale, but honestly I'm not a big fan of kale. I prefer to use spinach because spinach is also very nutritious and a lot more tastier. Anyway, so because I had the frozen spinach from the garden, I just defrost this instead of like doing it together with the onions, because the frozen spinach always have some liquid you want to drain. So I will just add this in the last minute. Okay, so I'm just gonna put a low heat for the onions because otherwise they're gonna start browning and this is not what we want. Okay, in the meantime, now we mush the sweet potatoes, we are going to... Oh, my oven is preheated. Anyway, so we're going to add the parchment paper to our dish because I always prefer to do it, so in case it's a little bit stuck to the bottom, you can still take it out of the pan when you use the parchment paper. So, let's do it. So honestly, I prefer to wash my hands and then push it in with my hands because you can just really feel what's happening. And anyways, it's just nice to work with the hands as well. The onion seems ready too. They're kind of looking transparent, so then they're also kind of soft. We're going to cut around the paper a little bit. So now we're going to add the spinach to the onions. Mix it nicely together, mix the flavors. We're going to add a little bit of salt. Nice! So now we're going to mix the rest of our ingredients. Our eggs, the yogurt and the cheese. We're going to whisk them with a whisk. So these are really nice eggs from my friend Mr. Don. Actually, this is the eggs from the chicken I steal in this music video. Anyways, let's just first whisk the eggs. Going to add our yogurt. Now time for, so this is goat cheese with some herbs inside, so it's always nice flavor. So goat cheese is a little easier on the digestive system than regular cheese, because the goat is like a smaller animal, so baby goat need less intense milk than baby cows. Anyways, this is nicely whisked. So now we're going to put half this mixture in our pan or in our mixture. Woo! This is starting to look really tasty. Now the rest of our spinach with onion. So just for the look, I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of paprika powder. So we have red, yellow, green. It's always a nice combination in food. Okay, so one option before I put this in the oven. Some people in the comments wrote that it was better to first bake the sweet potato separately to get it more like crusty. I haven't tried it yet, so I'm just going to follow the recipe for this one, and then I will give a comment on whether it would be a good idea to put in the crust before for some time to have more of a crusty crust. Anyways, let's put this in the oven. In the meantime, we're going to do some dishes. See you soon. So we are now about 20 minutes in. So we have the recipes, it's not going to be 55 minutes like it says, so we're just gonna keep an eye on it. Okay people, so this has been in the oven for 45 minutes, it looks like it's cooked, the outsides are puffing up, so time for taking it out. Okay people, so here it is fresh out of the oven. We're just going to let it cool for a little bit before we can start slicing, but so far everything looks nice and tasty. Okay, so here is the quiche after cooling down. So it looked like the sweet potato became part of the quiche. It's not really like crusty because it's kind of flexible. So yeah, let's cut one open. Okay people, it's time for taste testing. So, let's just go for it. Lots of flavor. So I think it's a really nice flavor with the goat cheese. And yeah, if the sweet potato didn't really make a crust, it's kind of more part of the quiche, like a quiche layer, not like crust and then egg quiche. So it has like its own little style. Flavor is really good. If you want it more crusty, I would put it like separately in the oven for a while, but I still like the flavor. The sweet potato is still like nice and juicy. Yeah, I really like it. Anyways, if you want to try it yourself, please leave your comments below on how you did it differently, or how you wish you did it differently. If you have any tips for me too, please feel free to share, we're all here to learn. So anyways, let's share with the family and see what happens. Baby approved. I hope you enjoyed this video and see you next time.